So I am, you're right. Right, opponents on Tron, so this game is basically unwinnable. We'll try though. This match is, I don't know, bordering on about a 5% win for me. Grab a swamp. I do have a Fairy Macabre in my hand, so if I can get a, playable cards, I might have a chance. But it's not looking good. I tapped wrong. Should have left my mana open so I could actually cycle the thicket. But I tapped wrong. Stop doing that. Basically, as soon as he gets Tron and plays a Muldrifter, the game's over. Get in the attacks. We will commune with the gods. Ooh, well, I gotta take the Torch of Existence there. Cycle the thicket. I'm not gonna play into a counterspell. Guess I'll just play a swamp and oh, just a stinkweed. In order to have a chance here, I have to have Torch of Existence on the table. So I can't just play into a counterspell against him. Of course, this probably means he gets to, like Impulse or Teachings or something. Just get whatever he needs. So I think this game is pretty much over because he has the Teachings. And with Prohibit, he'll never let me get Tordex on the table. So we're gonna go for the draft chaff beatdown plan until it becomes obvious that's not going to work. Should exile his teachings while I have a chance. Suppose there's no harm in playing Crypt Rats here. It's condescended. It's fun. Pretty sure I just lose now. Two is the no key, right? No, four is the no key. Okay, so there's Tron. Presumably followed up immediately by a Denrova Horror. No, Stonehorn. That might actually just be worse for me. Now let's get a Tree Folk. Get back this thicket and the Jungle Hollow. Cycle the thicket. I'm gonna fume spitter. Doesn't help much. Play it. Play a Jungle Hollow and pass. So all he needs is anything here. Mold Drifter, whatever. I basically scooped anything. Definitely scooping Toad and Robo. Yeah, unfortunately this match is just really not winnable. Got the Spore Frogs, bring in the Artifact and Land Hate. Spitters aren't good here. Cut those. And, need one more cut. I'm gonna just cut a Tusker. Well, mulligan, one land. We keep this solid hand. We send back brown scale. It is unfortunately some of the risk of playing Tordex. You just have no game at all against Tron. So by the forest or the thicket here. I think it's the forest. If I hit the land, then I can cycle the thicket and actually have a play for the tree folk to buy back. I might just cycle the thicket anyway. Kind of have to high roll here. If I cycle the thicket and I don't hit a land, though, the next two draws, I just lose. So I guess I'll just keep it. Pretty glad I didn't cycle the thicket. So we'll play a land pad, play the thicket, pass. Looks like he's going to have an easy Tron again. Play Wicker Ball, I can slow down the prisms at least. Okay, he doesn't just have natural Tron, so that's really good for me. This is kind of hard. There's a lead with Commune. That's actually a hard choice. I'll take the Mesmeric Fiend because I have a land pad. We'll blow up a prism. Attack for five. It's kind of hoping it lands off of that. Didn't quite work out for me. Okay, well, there's another land. That's good. Let's get in the beatdowns. We'll play a Mesmeric Fiend and sack it. Unless it gets countered. Damn. It's a pretty rough counter, too. And I can't even really do anything with my open mana. That sucks. So if I play a blind tree folk, I can get him down to four. I'm leaving pretty close to lethal. I'm gonna wait. Evoke Drifter. So I got two choices here. I can back a Wicker Ball, blow up the other prism. I'm gonna mulch chamber and hope I draw a land. I think the Wicker Ball is the safer play, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab that. He's got too many cards in hand, they're all gas. So I think the best thing I can do is just take him off of colored mana. Just draw another mull chamber. It's cool. So play another mull chamber. We'll blow up the prism. Stonehorn, okay. Another tree folk. It's pretty frustrating. Play is going to be a Scrabbler. Think I want to do it while he's tapped out too. Alright, so we'll get back a Mesmeric Fiend. Probably just a Crypt Rats. Maybe it's a Mold Chamber. I'm gonna get a second mold chamber. If I draw another land, then I can just do like mold chamber, mold chamber. What is this? Okay, that actually might stop lethal. Do I sack here? I'm gonna get him down to 4, or I'm gonna get him down to 3, in theory. Play a fiend. Won't be lethal. I attack like this, and he doesn't block, and I just sack two things, and he's okay. So we're gonna sack a Scrabble here. This threatens lethal if he doesn't do anything, so. It's probably like a moment's peace or something. Somewhere also. Okay. So play Mesmeric Fiend. Oh, he's got a prohibit. That's annoying. Oh well. Got mold chamber chains going on next turn. Knowledge of Chur. Drifty boy. Missionary. Alright, well, he's still in it. No sacrifices. He's looking at back a Scrabbler right now. I'm gonna get it back eventually anyway. Might as well be now. The lamp pad. To attack with Wicker Balls. And we'll blow up a power plant. This is how I beat Tron, basically, if they stumble. The only way I can beat them. And if my draw is pretty reasonable. Single block is pretty ballsy. Alright, so that's a win. Which is a nice start. The draws, the fiends are probably not as good. But are they better than, like, caterpillars? Probably. Let's run it back. It's a shame there's not one more land here. Keep this. Send back a swamp. Oops. Want a secure tribe? No prohibit's good. If he prohibited that, I'd have been in pretty bad shape. Grab a swamp. Got another swamp. Don't want to cycle the thicket. Don't want to play here. Which is another secure tribe and swamp. Alright, that hurts. Alright, we're gonna wait. Do prism. Cool. Gonna debate what I want to do with this thicket. I think I need to cycle it. Probably gonna cycle it now. Damn. That sucks. I'm in a great opportunity to land Tordex if I'm drawing it. Also sucks to cut myself off of the land. I think if he ephemerates here, I'm just dead. Yep. Rough. Pretty sure I just lose. Or the fiend in sack. Maybe his hand is somehow not all gas. Or this group will take the mnemonic ball. Two more mnemonic balls to go. If you hit a Denrova here, I'm dead. So that's a Denrova, which means I'm dead. Cool. Sadly, that is Tron. Go again. Tron, the fun police. Gab C. Fairies or Boros, I recognize the name. Not quite sure what he's on. No green, got a mulligan. Think I can do better than this. Keep this one. Just toss away the fairy macabs. Not sure if I'm gonna need them. Forests. Hexproof? Okay. This is beatable. I gotta find Tordex and Spore Frogs real quick. Kept a hand with no white source, so It's pretty good for me. Cycle this thicket. Play a wild, grab a swamp. Sadly, he drew into his white source. So I'm pretty fooked. Let's see, he doesn't have first strike yet. So I could play the Stinkweed. Might turn off his attack. Let's do that. And if it doesn't, then I get a Stinkweed in the graveyard. Which is not the worst. Even did not draw first strike. Okay, he drew first strike, so I'm dead. Cool. Alright, so we want all the enchantment hate, extra Spore Frog, Chainer's Edict, a Wicker Boss. I think Mold Chamber is actually too slow for this matchup. Get rid of all these cards right here. Tusker is definitely too slow for this matchup. We don't need Fairy Macabs. So suppose I can fit in one Mold Chamber. And let's go. Not much I can do against a turn 4 kill when I'm on the draw. I think I was on the draw. I don't remember. Match should get a lot better after board. Of course, he's probably going to bring his enchantment hate too, so that's also a problem. Yeah, we'll keep this for sure. I'll just lead off the caterpillar. Should ideally stop him from playing like abundant growth and whatnot. We shall see. Commune here. Got some lands in the graveyard. This kind of sucks. Need to draw some of those lands. Alright, that really sucks. So play a Fume Spitter, play a Spore Frog. Just get in the beatdowns, I guess. Kill him with a bunch of 1/1s. Okay. Really sucks. Really sucks not drawing any lands. Seems actually great if I just draw lands. Attack with Fume Spitter and Spore Frog. I'm gonna lose my caterpillar and then have him play like another dude and then an ethereal armor or something like that. Annoying. I'm just gonna plan on this poor frog. If he plays like an armadillo cloak or something, then I'll just fog him and blow it up next turn. Since I'm not drawing any freaking lands. Gonna have to get stuff on board. Hey, drew another one. That's pretty sweet. And they beat downs. Play another caterpillar. Ouch, that one actually kind of hurts. I can't do anything about that. All I need is another land. Like a rot farm would be the best draw. Yeah. Sucks. That was what I was afraid of. I'm gonna fog this. Cool. Rot farm. The best draw. So we're gonna blow up the armadillo cloak. Play the rot farm. Bounce the forest. Last turn. Plays another lifelink like enchantment, then I'll fog. If not, then I'll just take whatever hit he throws at me. Of course, he had the other one. It's frustrating. Alright, now I gotta debate whether I want to try and continue to race him or not. I think the answer is no. I don't think I'm gonna continue to try and race him. I'll win the long game, I think. So I need to save the Spore Frog activations. Now this is an interesting one. Play a Wicker Ball. Or I play a Crypt Rats. I'm gonna play the Wicker Ball. Give me a little bit more flexibility next turn, so I can play like a Spore Frog and blow up an enchantment as well. If he plays a big enchantment, then I'll fog. If not, then I'll take five. course, he could just, like, cave here. There's not much I can do about that. Okay. So, obviously fogging. Now I just hope he doesn't have, like, another ram through. That would suck. Oh god, he has it, doesn't he? No, no, it's Skyfisher. Whew, dodge that bullet. Got another bullet now that I have to dodge, which is a Skyfisher. I don't think I need to do anything about the Skyfisher yet. I'll just wait. So let's blow up the Ancestral Mask. Oh, I'm stupid. I almost missed this line of play too. So now I can blow up the Armadillo Cloak as well. With the Fume Spitter. Do I want to? Probably. So I can use the Fume Spitter to put a counter back on Wicker Ball. Blow up the Armadillo Cloak. And I just have to deal with a 2-3 flyer. And then hopefully he doesn't have any other enchantments that'll mess me up. And I can play Crypt Rats too. Alright. So let's counter back on the Wicker Ball. Blow up the Armadillo Cloak. Play Crypt Rats. Pass. Him to not land another big enchantment. Ideally. I think his other card in hand that he's been holding on to is some kind of an enchantment hate for the Tordax. Okay, so he's caving with Skyfisher, which is smart. It means Crypt Rats can't kill it. A commune. It's nonsense. I'll play Spore Frog here. I don't know if I want to attack the ball. Probably double blocks. So then he puts the Rancor on the Skyfisher. It takes 6, down to 5. I don't know, he just single blocks. That's fine. Cool. I can deal with that. Pretty happy with that. God, that commune was nonsense. Dead to a fling. I'm gonna Spore Frog here. I don't want to die to fling. So half the deck, haven't seen Tordex. Pretty sweet. I'm dead to like Ethereal Armor, I think. Now I can just pop Creep Paths for one. Which I might just do. Take three. Down to eight. Think I have to. Play a Wicker Ball here. Turns off my Crypt Rats. That might have been a mistake. I don't know. Sack for Swamp. Pass turn. I can still blow up a big enchant one big enchantment as long as he doesn't have more than one. It'll be fine. So we might just be in a holding pattern here. Chainer's Edict's actually a pretty good draw. Alright, so pop Crypt Rats for one. Chainer's Edict him. Hit four, nine. Eight. Edict was actually a fantastic draw. Oh man, you got another Skyfisher. That sucks. Not good enough yet, though. He needs to hit more than just one Skyfisher. Okay, he's got a boggle. It'll stop lethal. And a mask. Cool, I'll blow that up. Commune. Does he find six? Not enough. Let's commune, see if we can find something to actually kill him. Tordex will do it. Well, it won't quite do it well. Tordex will give me like a Spore Frog. I think regardless, he has to block both the Wicker Boss. Both his dudes are gonna die. Oh, well, he just doesn't block. Okay. I might want Eruvs for the Skyfishers. I'm gonna bring that in. What's up, Twizman? Oh man. Oh, thanks. That's cool. I beat one game of Tron. Then he stopped me the other two games. This is round two, and I'm 1-1 against Boggles. Game one, I got turned forward. Game two, you just watched, and we're on to game three. Oh, Tordex and six lands. If it wasn't like a super aggressive deck, I would actually keep this, but I can't keep that. We'll keep this one. Some Mech of Groundscale. An Elder. Hopefully, it just goes all in on the Boggle and I can just Chainer's Edict it on turn three. Wicker Ball's nice. Alright, so I need him to not play another Boggle for two turns and then somehow not die. Another Wilds. I think I'm still just playing a Rot Farm here. So, don't play another creature. Don't play another creature. Don't play another creature. Okay. It's good. It's not another creature. Like a Rancor or another Ethereal Armor. It'd be perfect. Sweet. Alright, so let's edict him. Debating here whether I actually play Tordex or not. So I don't want to just like die to a random enchantment removal. I don't know, I do have commune, but don't have anything to get out of the graveyard of Tordex right now anyway. I'll just play a Wilds. Get a swamp. It was kind of close there. I get a feeling like he brought in Enchantment Hate. So I actually want to be able to use Tordex before I. Kind of regret not getting Forest now. I think we're just gonna go with Secure Tribe, Swamp. Secure Tribe will fetch a forest. This lets me play Wicker Ball and blow up an enchantment next turn. Then actually use my Tordex to get like the Secure Tribe back. So fetch a forest. I think he's just out of creatures. Oh hey, I drew another Tordex. That makes things easier. Let's commune, fill up the graveyard with useful stuff. Secure Tribe and Spore Frog. I'm just gonna take on the Secure Tribe. I don't need the Spore Frog right now. Oops. Let's play the Tordex. That's kind of what I figured. But I've got a backup. Four Steves has been awesome. I love Four Steves. I think I'm going to hang on to the other Tordax. Just play a Wicker Ball. He has to answer Wicker Ball. He might have a couple creatures, but he's holding on to them because of Chainer's Edict in the yard. He knows I can just kill whatever creature he plays. So, I mean, right now he has to answer me, not the other way around. All right, Arius, nice draw. Skyfisher, as expected. So we'll kill the Skyfisher. Take off the yields on that. Ram through. Interesting. Okay. Tree Folk gets me a couple lands. It's pretty sweet. We'll take the Wilds, the Jungle Hollow, play the Wilds, thin out the deck a little bit. I don't even really know what I'm looking for, just don't want to draw any more lands really. Just saw your message. I'm like, I'm not really sure where the R belongs there. I think it's how are the Four Steves. I guess next turn I can play the Tordex and get back like Air Use and the Spore Frog or something. It's cute. It's not gonna work, but it's cute. And that's that game. Cool. Didn't even need Tordex. Just a handful of hate cards. Finish this match and go to bed. Just got off on night shift. So, a little bit tired. Normally I wouldn't be streaming my league grinding after I get off of night shift, but I feel like I've been remiss in my streaming as of late. That's cool. I'm glad. I'm glad people enjoy watching. I had a... So I made this Twitch affiliate thing and kind of had a little bit of a come to Jesus moment, I suppose. So I'm like, I don't... No, does that mean I'm supposed to be like a high quality streamer? Does that mean I'm supposed to have some kind of a schedule? What does that really mean? I don't know. Does that mean I'm doing good? Because I certainly don't feel like I've been doing good. I don't have any kind of a consistent schedule at all because my work schedule's not consistent. No, I don't have a pro microphone or a gaming PC, and my internet's shoddy at best. My stream is probably lagged as hell. And, yeah. I mean, thank you. I appreciate that. It's kind of like a imposter syndrome going on, though, you know? I don't have overlays. I don't even know if I have a subscribe button now attached to my channel or something like that. Who the fuck knows? Am I supposed to run ads? You know? Am I supposed to contact Wizards of the Coast and become a... I don't know, their streamer program thingy that they got going on? Of course, they probably would prefer not to have MTGO streamers at all. They probably want people to stream Arena. I'm just really not interested in whatever the hell's going on over there. I don't know if you can see it, but it kind of making me blush. Dum to dum. See, so I'm like curious because I don't even know what my stream actually looks like right now. Full screen it. That's cute. It's not what I wanted at all. Let's exit that. Pop out. Maybe this. Alright, see, so I'm like, I got this thing, but there's no like subscribe button, right? I'm supposed to have a subscribe button. I don't know where the fuck that is. Yeah. So I've got the follow button, right? And there's, I mean, for me, I have a gift a sub. I assume this is where you guys have the subscribe button. I'm not going to tell you guys subscribe. I don't feel like I deserve subscriptions yet. I don't even have a microphone. I'm going to have this overlay. Sorry, I'm going to turn that off now, because otherwise you'll get echoes or whatever in my voice. So, like, there's so much you don't know about streaming. Like, you know, the overlays and stuff that's going on like that. And the subscribe buttons and, like, you know, if I do start eventually getting subscribers or followers or whatever, I don't know how to, like, you know, you watch other people's streams, like, whenever some subscribes or followers, they'll get, like, a little notification or whatever on their screen. I don't know how to set that shit up. I don't know anything. And the tutorials are all, like, you know, how to get your, expand your viewership and whatever. And I'm like, I'm not even there yet. I'm like, let's go back to step one of setting up the stream. Sand doesn't do anything. I'm mulligan. Sand doesn't do much either, but I'm going to keep this one. I'll toss back brown scale. It's the most useless in the vacuum. Another hexproof deck. I don't have a great hand for hexproof, so I'm hoping he stumbles. Or I draw a Tordex and then like a Spore Frog immediately. Okay, Cartouche, not the most aggressive thing you could be playing. But if he's got anything else, then it's gonna be pretty rough. Right now I'm 1-1 in the league. I lost in round 1 to Tron. Probably has like a ram through or something here to kill this thing. No, he just didn't play his Armadillo Cloak first. It's cute. So I lost round 1 to Tron, I won round 2 to Hexproof. Or won round 2 against Hexproof, I should say. I'll play Mesmeric Fiend here so I don't die to like an Ancestral Mask or something. Take the Ethereal Armor. It's doing a lot of help here. Got this 4/4 First Strike Trampler that I can't deal with. And he just draws another Ethereal Armor. That's cute. Alright, so I need Spore Frog and Tordex pretty quick. Pretty quick. Got another Scrabbler. Pretty useless. Let's just play Crypt Rats. Not much else I can do here. I'll take 7. I think I'm just dead. I played a Scrabbler as a blocker. Oh, is that Reichenwald's name is? Alright, well, it's dead. Yeah, he just ripped the Ethereal Armor and then Ancestral Mask. I can't beat that. So I'll bring in the same sideboarding strategy last time. I don't think he's running Skyfishers, although maybe he is. I'll cut these, cut these. What the hell? He just conceded the match. Okay. I'll take it. Alright. I don't know why he conceded a match. He won game one. Yeah, that video's awesome, man. I hope Pro Bosch keeps on doing this. That shit made me laugh. That was like quality content right there. Yeah, well, it's the nature of the internet. It's the nature of the internet, Zimps. Shitpost gets more feedback than actual content. Yeah, we have.
Say it. Stay away from it. All right, cool.
Moving on. That's why you see, though, like, you see any drama behind, like, I don't know, like, fucking popular YouTubers are like, what the fuck was his name? Logan Paul or some shit. Right? Nobody knew who the fuck he was until he shitposted in Japan in the Suicide Fortis. I don't know who the fuck he was. I mean, people knew who he was, right? He was like a famous YouTuber or whatever, but nobody really cared who he was until he shitposted in the Suicide Forest. I mean, the same thing with like PewDiePie or whatever. Nobody actually knew or cared who he was until they dug up like Nazi shit on him. Or his anti-Semitism, whatever the fuck he was. I don't know. I can't keep up with this drama. It's nonsense. But like, that kind of controversy gets you more coverage and more feedback, positive or negative, than actual quality shit. You know?
Oh, man.
That is horrific. Which one is that? Logan Paul or PewDiePie? That eats cereal with water. Oh. Okay. You laugh, but I know people have done that kind of shit. I was in the military for a while, and some of the people have just the weirdest fucking tics about how they eat and with certain kinds of things. I knew a guy who had, you know, we'd have morning you know, for breakfast, we have like biscuits and stuff. There's a guy who would dip his biscuits in tropical punch juice to eat. It was like milk to him. Yeah. There's another guy who would who would dip his hot dogs and hot dog buns in water. And he said that was, yeah, it's bizarre. Then we have this kind of milk. This milk we call UHT. It's ultra high temperature milk. It means it was pasteurized at a higher than normal pasteurization temperature. And there were guys who preferred that milk to like regular normal milk that you get at the grocery store, for example. And I will tell you, this UHT milk tasted terrible. It was an alright substitute for milk, as long as you're eating it with like cereal or something. Something that like sugared it the fuck up, you know? And masked how terrible it was. Lindoso. Normally only Boros, I think. This is a good hand. I keep this. It's got a commune. It's got a secure tribe. Yeah, it's Boros. It's cool. This is a pretty even matchup for me, actually. It's about 50-50. Find a Torx. Did not find a Torx. Rip. It's not set in stone. It depends on if I can find Tordex, and if he has an Oblivion Ring. Some of these lists play Oblivion Ring, some don't. I've got a lot of card advantage going for me right now, so I feel pretty good at the moment. Monarch. Alright. It's ballsy. I'll go ahead and take that monarchy and get a Tordex for my troubles. Sick. So let's take the monarchy. Oh, he does have strands, doesn't he? That's shit. I should have Fairy Macabre it. Damn. Alright, well, no big deal. I'll make him use the strands. Sure, Sax Beam Spear. Whoops. Alright. No more punts. We're gonna stop punting now. I feel like I shouldn't Fairy Macabre. Just got a Fume Spitter. Right, so he has a fucking O-ring. So that's kind of the defining factor here, is whether or not he has O-ring. And he has Mianota. Find another Tordax. Sweet. Got it. Got him. We'll see if he lets me have the monarchy. Okay, it's not gonna let me have the monarchy. That's fine. I wasn't really expecting to take it. What are the chances he has the second O-ring? He doesn't have a second O-ring, right? So now I just need to dredge and hit. Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? Wow. I'm gonna save my stinkweed. You get both my tree folk. No, just one of my tree folk. It's frustrating.
Not dredging over a brown scale is super frustrating. Not a brown scale. Scrabbler. It's pretty frustrating there.
Blow this up while he doesn't have his trans open. could just be dead to double Galvan bolt here. Well, he didn't bounce his bog. No. He's gonna bounce the bog now. Alright. I need to dredge over a Scrabbler here. That's why I say that game one's not set in stone. Because he can just keep on bouncing his fucking bog. Yeah, there's the Scrabbler. It's good news. Grab the land pad, grab his Cur Tribe. Leave open mana to get back my Scrabbler for when he tries to bog it. He bolts my face. I'm out of sacrifice the Scrabbler here. Because this means he's just going to go for the try and burn me out plan. Yeah, he played a land like that. It means he's going to just burn me out. He's going to double Galv Blast me here. Yep. Alright, so game one's rough. Didn't help they had the right crap to beat me. Alright, so we basically bring in like our entire sideboard. Got the Spore Frogs. Got the Macabs. I also punted pretty hard with the Prismatic Strands, so there's that as well. I'm gonna leave in one Fairy Macabre for the Strands. It's not good enough. This hand will do. Man, I'm gonna play around a bog every turn. Sucks too. Caterpillar might just turn off his turn one land drop when he has artifact lands. It did not. I was not so lucky. Just gonna play Steve's here. Don't need to commune yet. Steve will thin out the deck a little bit, fix the mana a little bit. You're gonna bolt the Caterpillar? Yep. That's cool. Because in that case, he spends his bolt on Caterpillar instead of, you know, like a Crypt Rats or something. So I don't regret that at all. So here, I think Steve's actually gonna get a Forest. Tordex. Sweet. Do I even play it though? It's commune. Oh man, like I want all of these. Wicker Ball's the best one to take in this situation, though. So we can Steve now. Play the Wicker Ball, blow up this Great Furnace. Does he have that? Every time. It's frustrating. Took my freaking mold chamber too. Ugh. He probably has enchantment hate. Brown skill's great draw. Really good draw. Let's gain some life. I know he's got a bog. Maybe I'm going to hold on to the brown scale. Nah. Just going to get the secure tribe on the table, probably. May not even play it, actually. Thinking about it. Because if he kills it and then bogs me, I have nothing. I want to be able to get this, get a creature in the yard. I want to be able to get a creature in the yard so I can dredge and draw more. It's annoying. He's had like really, really good draws against me. Normally they don't, like, Boros doesn't draw this well against me normally. But he's just had amazing draws. I'd like to draw no more lands now. Ideally. Cool. Cool. That's pretty good. Still didn't manage to draw a Scrabbler. That's insane. miss two life gain with the brown scale. Now he's gonna go Skyfisher, bounce the bog, replay the bog. No, I can't even fucking beat that. Fuck that. I can never beat that card. Alright, might as well finish out the league. I'll keep this one. Yeah, I'm never beating an Aura Fracture in 100 years. Unless I already had access to the enchantment removal creature. And had like a backup Tordex in my hands. Alright, so we're against Fae, and I have a Tordex on the table, so I pretty much win this game. And I've got three lands. The ninja. 100%, it's always a ninja. As long as I can keep on hitting my land drops here, it barely matters how many cards he draws with the ninja. And now I've got a brown skull in the yard, I can start cycling that and gaining life too. I'll be fine. Spore Frog, and then when he counters it, I'll get it back with the Scrabbler. You can counter it, it's weird. The hell do I do now? So weird, I just expect people to counter shit. Let's play Mesmeric Fiend, I guess. Take the fire ice. I don't want him to tap my Golgari Rot Farm next turn without paying for it. Figures he top deck the bolt immediately. It's cool.
Oh.
Need to find some land creatures. Dear God.
Yep.
I'm just gonna play a Spore Frog and a Fume Spitter. I'm gonna stop this stupid ninja from hitting me. I'm done trying to keep track of what cards he has in his hand. He has a lot of cards in his hand. They're probably all good. I don't know why he even attacked there. Flogged him. I assumed he was gonna ninja, but that's not what happened. So I don't know what the purpose of that attack was. Let's get back another Fume Spitter. Mostly so I can dredge. Cool, got a Scare Tribe. Perfect. That's what I wanted. Who's gonna counter Scrabbler? Guess let's find out. That's fine. I didn't really want the Scrabbler anyway. Just want the Scare Tribe.
Come on, tell me, tree folk, where are you at?
You're not telling tree folk. You're not telling tree folk at all. Wow, expected that to get spell stuttered. It did not. Yeah, I really want to resolve a Scare Tribe again, but I don't think he'll let it. I think I'm just gonna play a Spore Frog. Alright, maybe he will let a Scare Tribe resolve. I'm gonna give it a shot. Sick. Really wasn't expecting that. Get a Scrabbler back from the yard. All the curves in the world don't matter. You can't beat endless creatures. So the main mistake he's making here is he's letting me get mana. By letting me get mana, and by continuing to target the creatures that I can sacrifice, for I don't even know what reason, he is just letting me build my advantage more and more. So we want to get Skur Tribe. I want to resolve a Scrabbler. Yeah, might as well. The lands can wait, I'm fine. Let's get another Scrabbler. I'll get a Ferry Macabre too. Stop his silly sanctuary nonsense. Dredge a Stinkweed, and sure to find a Tilling Tree Folk. Sure of it. Not doing anything, huh? It's interesting. Still did not find a Tilling Tree Folk. Into the beatdowns with Scrabbler. Cool. As expected, opponent blocked. And we shall get back a Fume Spitter. round scale. Probably counters the fume spitter.
Yep.
As expected, it's fine. I know he's got another ninja in his hand. He's probably gonna ninja me here. Put Stinkweed in the yard, getting back a Fume Spitter. I haven't seen any Crypt Rats either. It's kind of annoying. I haven't seen Crypt Rats or Tilling Tree Folk. Or taken either. Jesus Christ. Still haven't seen either. Dum-da-dum. Yeah, give me your spell stutter. I know. Kill the fairy. Sacrifice the Scrabbler. Get it back. Okay. Scrabbler, get back a land pad. And a Fume Spitter. All right, what am I fairy macabbing today? Scred? Cool. Give her a Scred and Deprive. Ugh. How the fuck? Oh, there's Crypt Rats.
Jesus Christ.
I doubt it. Freak out there, but I didn't draw something. So, Crypt Rats. Cool. Now, so this match, I like cutting Spore Frogs, I like bringing in Wicker Boss. Because they tend to bring in relics.
Not a lot of them, but they do bring them in.
And oofs. I actually don't like Mesmeric Fiends as good as they may seem. Dead weights are good. I usually cut. I think Sakura Tribes. They don't really block anything from them. And is needs land, but it's fine. We keep it. A dead weight to stop like turn one fairy or turn two ninja even. Alright. He lands. Land is the best draw. Did not get it. I'm not gonna play into a spell shatter. One land. It's not ideal as far as lands go, but it is land. It's commune. See if it counters this. Nope. I'm gonna take a Tusker here because I just needed the land drops, and he'll make sure I do that. Still think I'm not playing into a spell starter. Just no need to yet. And this is why I brought in Wicker Boss. Play Stinkweed. It asks him to have hard counterspell, and if he doesn't, then that's fine by me too. Because Stinkweed kind of just stops whatever creatures he tries to play, like the fairies and stuff. Another one. All right, so let's grab ourselves another land. Got two lands. Pretty sweet. Still think I'm not interested in playing Spellstutter, so just play a land pad. I think I can get Torvex on the table this turn. So let's get the spell starter. Wasn't expecting Crypt Rats to resolve. Let's play Rot Farm, bounce Tranquil, bounce the Thicket. Guess I shouldn't have attacked with Stinkweed. Like, I want to get ninja'd here. Gonna pop off the Crypt Rats. Cycle the thicket first, see what we get. Prayer Macabre. It's not bad. Let's just play the Tree Folk and get back the thicket. Cool, another Crypt Rat, good one. Really don't want to get ninja. I want to get end of turn spell starter plus ninja. Just pass. This is hard. I think it's one relic is one thing. Two is harder. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna attack with these dudes. I'm going to play Crypt Rats. It's probably it's a counter spell. Okay, since it didn't need a counter spell, I'm just gonna pass. Oh. All right, I think I can get rid of one of these relics now. Gonna bring in mulch chambers next time. Or draw lands when I need them, only when I'm like super flooded already. Yep, now I'm getting injured. I think I lose now. I lose because he got two ninjas.
Or two relics.
Gonna cast it. It's time to just beat down. Let's go to game three. I'm not interested in trying to play around these stupid relics anymore. So I'm bringing in mold chambers now. Let's take out the Sakura tribes. Got one dead weight. Not like this. I'm gonna try and commune on turn two, rather than playing a Fume Spitter. I just got it, don't I? Frustrating. I don't even have an answer to it this game. No, at least I can land Tordex this game. It's gonna fill up our graveyard. Damn, it's a hard choice actually. I'm gonna take Wicker Ball. Range on untapped land, that'd be great. Damn. I'm actually just gonna play this though. Maybe it'll pop off the relic. Okay, that's cool. That is perfectly fine by me. Should have grabbed a forest. Oopsie. We can get anything too valuable off of that. So now I get ninja'd. Cool, cool. Kill the fairy. I'm going to Tordex back the fume spitter and the tree folk. Damn, he hit the bolt.
That sucks.
He didn't use it. That's bizarre. The fuck didn't he use it? Pass. Let's see if he counters this. If he does, I can land a land pad, which would be pretty sweet. I'm probably just gonna go for the land pad anyway, honestly. Can't be spell stuttered, so. Good deal. Alright, I've got a good board now. Feeling pretty safe. Relatively speaking. He's also discarded his other mountain. I think these lists usually run two mountains. So if I can draw a mold chamber, that'd be awesome. Dredger would be great too. Another swamp, not so great. It's annoying. All right. Scrabbler. It's pretty sweet. Okay. Fine by me. I'll do it again.
Oh.
Go, boys. We're doing it. 3-2 incoming. Spell. Yep. I'll do it again. Counter spell. All right, cool. Chain of treasure. Treasure or Crypt Rats. I don't know. Let's start attacking with Wicker Ball. Oh.
How many dredges is he exiled?
He hasn't exiled any dredgers. So I think when I finally hit one, I'll be good to go. Another Tordex. That'll be good for whenever he draws his Echoing Truth, I suppose. It's annoying. Come on, Dredger. Give me a dredge. Tree folk.
Oh, he probably has more spell stutters and shit.
Well, fuck it, I'm gonna go for it. Yep. Fuck. It's gonna deprive too. Sucks. Might actually lose this. It's got the deprive lock now. And I don't have a fairy cob stopping. Dredge. Me dredge. Motherfuck. Spoke too soon. Spoke too soon. I'd also take a brown scale. I mean, a brown scale would get me out of range. Can't play anything right now. He's got a deprive. So I need to hit more than one thing. Brown scale, I think, is an instant win. Two brown skills is even better. Cool. All right. Can get out of range now. That is the match. Sweet. Well, there's another 3-2 with Tordex. Let's open up this chest. Ten play points and an Apocalypse Hydra. Pretty sure that's worthless. It's almost certainly worthless. Thank you guys for watching me kill the stream now and head to bed.